Hey guys, my name is JessiMew, and welcome back to Slime Rancher. In the last episode, we dipped our toes into the ancient ruins, and we found some pretty interesting things. Of course, we have our brand new friends, the Quantum Slimes, who are going to be very, very interesting to try to pin down. They seem like quite mischievous creatures, so I bet when we combine them with all of our little tabby slimes, they are going to be even more fun to deal with. But we also found these little echoes, and I placed them down here so I would have more room in my vacpack to do some slime maintenance, of course, but they seem to be perfectly content just shining away right next to our home. So I thought we would do a little bit of reading about the echoes because they seem quite mysterious too. They're unique to the ancient ruins, and a lot of you have said that we can just use them for decoration, so I want to see if they have any special little tips about them inside the Slimepedia. They're way down at the bottom of the resources tab. They said that they're perhaps a memory too, so I wonder if that's how these things are created. They're a unique type of item, they're certainly not food, and within the crumbling walls of the ancient ruins, small traces of energy can be found, never staying in one place for very long. Called echoes, they are believed to be a phenomenon resulting in some kind of ancient event. Since they are harmless, echoes are often collected by ranchers as good luck charms or used as decorations. Alright, so we can just throw them around our ranch and let them light the way, I suppose. Echoes appear regularly in the nooks and crannies of the ancient ruins, as well from extractors. Oh, so I wonder if we place some our extractors in the ancient ruins, if we would get some of the echoes? That's interesting. We're going to have to make some more of those and place them in different places around the world. And on the ranch, echoes can be used as decorations. Simply vac them up and shoot them wherever you want. They'll hover in that spot until you vac them up. Excellent! Okay, so I guess we can just throw these wherever we want. We have a green one, we have some blue ones, and we have some little tiny red ones too. And you know, that does remind me that we never actually joined the 7Z Rewards Club, so we might want to give that a try too if we're going to spend some time decorating our ranch. Could we even like put them in the air? Oh my gosh, we can! They'll float right next to our house. They almost look like little Christmas lights actually if we line them up like this. We can put them all around our house so it'll glow in the dark. That is so cool. I can't wait to see what that's going to look like when it is actually dark. But before we go and join the 7Z Corporation, let's make sure our brand new friends are settled in. Luckily, we do have a little extra corral space down by the lab itself, so we can make a nice big upgraded corral right away for these guys. Let's put them right up here in the first spot next to our barn. It's probably a good idea to isolate them a little bit further away from the rest of the slimes too, because if you guys haven't seen how the quantum slimes act yet, then you will be very, very surprised. They have these like very strange spirit essences that come out of them almost. They look very, very glitchy, and I'm a little bit concerned that they're going to find a way to sneak out of here if we're not careful. But let's throw them in here for now so we can have a little bit more space. And then we're going to have to, oh my goodness, find some sort of food for them to eat. I think that's the music box, isn't it? It's actually making the same sound as that giant door that we opened to even get to the ancient ruins. That is adorable. So you guys are going to feel right at home listening to that lovely sound. But yeah, let's go find some fruit for them to eat. I don't think we actually have their favorite fruit. Let's just check that very quickly. I have a feeling it's probably that strange tree that we found inside the ruins. Yeah, the phase lemon. So we have to figure out how we're going to harvest those up so we can grow those on the ranch too. But for now, I'm sure we can find some pogo fruits. We had so many pogo fruits stashed away inside our silo so we could feed that giant honey gordo. And he seemed very, very happy with it all. So I'm sure that our quantum slimes will be pretty happy too. It's not their favorite, but it'll have to do for now. So let's shoot this straight into their corral first. Ah yes, there we go. There's that very, very glitchy spirit that they seem to let out, but I think they're still inside the corral, right? Where are you going? Are you going into the sun? You're on the very tippity top of my barn. Oh my goodness. Yeah, this is why I am very happy that we're isolating our creatures, our little quantum slimes. Probably a good idea. And oh no, you're very hungry. There you go. Eat away at all of those pogo fruits, little one. That one's going into the tree or the cliffside. Oh, this is going to be a very interesting for us to watch, especially once we turn them into tabbies. We'll throw the rest of the pogo fruits into the auto feeder, though, so they'll be nice and well-fed if we go exploring today. And then we'll go try to find some tabby plorts. It shouldn't be too hard for us because we do have so many of the tabbies on our ranch. We'll just snag one from one of the the many, many corrals over on the main side. It looks like our chickens are doing pretty well too. Hello, guys. None of you are too old, right? Yeah, it looks like you're all very healthy, giving us lots of little chickadoos. So hopefully pretty soon we can go back and try to feed that big hunter gordo as well. But let's try to find a couple of these tabby plorts. We might as well take some extras too, because we know we're going to need quite a few of these to make the different items inside the lab. Oh my goodness! And our boom slimes are very, very angry back here. Do you guys have enough food? I think you might be a little bit hungry. Yeah, we seem to be out of chickens at the moment, so I don't want you guys hopping out. We're gonna pick up a few of these that we have kind of strutting around the ranch right now and send them straight in for you guys to eat. Gotta make sure that all of our slimes are happy and fed. And we'll check out that extractor too once we finish up with our quantum slimes. We'll see if we got anything different from the extractor on that side of the ranch. And yeah, we are definitely going to make some more apiaries, some more pumps and drills, and bring them to different places to see what happens. But for now, you guys, let's see what you look like as some tabby hybrids. We did see these guys in the ancient ruins though. Oh, they are so cool. I love that swirly pattern and their glowing eyes too. It's very, very mysterious. You guys are going to be causing so much trouble in the future. I can already tell. I mean, just judging by those little ghostly spirits that you like to send out in strange places, just like that one. Oh my goodness. Isn't that just like a cat to sit at the very tippity top of the highest place they can find? That is adorable. We might also want to make a little pogo fruit tree right next to their corral so that we'll have plenty of food to give them until we can find their very favorite thing. But let's throw some more plorts in the refinery and then we'll go over here and see if we can make any more of those extractors. So we have plenty of those pink plorts thanks to all of the pink slimes right outside our ranch. And look at all those tabby plorts too. Oh, we are not going to be running out of those anytime soon. But yeah, I do want to somehow find these like deep brine things because we need those to make all of the different patches of grass. And I'm assuming we can use them as decorations just like it says. So I would love to decorate the ranch with all of this beautiful grass. But first we need the deep brine and the hexacomb too. So we'll see if we can get that today. We'll make some of these novice drills, we'll make some of the novice pumps, and we'll make some of the novice apiaries too. I feel like the apiaries would probably be best in like the moss blanket or the overgrowth, because we do have a lot of honey slimes there, so it would make sense if they would help our apiaries. Then the drill seems like maybe it would be best in the quarry? I'm not 100% sure, and I don't really know where we would want to put the pump either, but we'll have to experiment a little bit until we can find something new. Our chickens love this dancing machine though, so let's see what we received from this. Oh, just a little bit of jellystone, unfortunately. We already have plenty of that. So yeah, this time let's see if we can put these in different places around the world. Different places for different resources. That'll give us a good chance to look around for more of those treasure pods too. We're looking in all of the nooks and crannies of this world to try to find all of those treasure pods again. Oh my gosh, there's one back here! Oh my goodness, and it's a green one too, so we can actually open it right now and see what's inside. Excellent. Yeah, we found so many of these before. Is that the deep brine? Oh my gosh, it actually is the deep brine in the hexacomb. Are you kidding me? And is that a strange diamond? Okay, so we finally have the deep brine that we need in the hexacombs too. That means that we can make some little patches of grass. Let's see, I think it would be right over here, just like how we make our extractors. If we go over to our coral grass patch, then we're only missing our puddle plorts. We need the quantum plorts too to make the verdant grass patch that we found inside the ancient ruins. And since our quantum slimes are right next to the lab, anyway, let's just suck these up and see if we can make some nice green grass for all of our quantum slimes to enjoy. I'm not sure if we would be able to place these inside their corrals or just around the ranch like we do for our extractors. Let's see how this works. We'll make our very first decoration on the entire ranch. And then I think if we go into gadget mode, we should be able to place this. We might as well just try to place it right next to their corral so they can enjoy the nice lovely grass. Yeah, we can install it right here. here. Oh my gosh, how adorable is that? A tiny little patch of green grass, even with some amass on the side too. So you guys can get a little bit of a taste of home, even when you're on our ranch in the middle of this very, very strange lab. You have the music, the lovely music that will remind you of your home door, and the grass too. That is too cute. But now we have plenty of new bucks left over. So before we go out for the day to try to place down some more of our extractors, let's see if we can join the 7Z Rewards Club. And not only that, but Casey actually sent us another letter in between episodes, so we do need to read our star mail too. New Year's Eve. Hi, Bia. Do you remember New Year's Eve when we were looking for that party? While we were wandering around the city lost, I got my bearings and didn't tell you because I knew we were close to that coffee shop run by the tyrant. And since it was starting to rain, I thought it would be really romantic to stumble across the place again. I guess I finally found the courage. But the coffee shop went out of business and it was a taco place now. So we ate tacos in the rain and it was just the best thing. We were on the roof of your old apartment, hoping to see the fireworks. I was going to tell you something then, but that's when you told me about Africa. It sounded like an amazing trip. I was really happy you were doing what you love to do, from Casey. Oh, that is so sweet. So yeah, definitely seems like they were in something of a relationship back at home. Casey must miss her dearly too, because they're sending her so many letters. I hope we're sending some back too. We want Casey to know that we're safe and sound after all and having the time of our lives on this ranch. So yeah, the 7Z Rewards Club. We haven't even joined yet. We need to become an initiate for the Roostro Weather Vane. And I'm assuming this is probably going to pop up right on the top of our little ranch, right? Let's see if it's on the top of our house. Yeah, there it is, the Roostro Weather Vane, excellent. So I guess the Rewards Club is going to give us some little decorations for all of the new bucks that we spend. Let's see if that's the case. We have plenty more left, so we could always buy another one of these upgrades too. We'll get the fence upgrade if we spend 1,000 new bucks. Oh boy, this is going to suck away all of our new bucks, isn't it? Rank 3 will give us a path upgrade, so let's buy that one too. And let's see what this is going to look like. We're going to have a fence and a path somewhere on our ranch. Oh, this right here. Oh my gosh, how cool does this look? Now we have a beautiful fence separating all of our slimes from our lovely gardens. Our Q-berries, I bet our quantum slimes would like some of this too. And all of our lovely little heartbeats over here, which we should probably feed to our rock slimes before we leave. But now that everyone is nice and well fed, let's head back to the moss blanket to see if we can place down any of those extractors. We'll see if we can place some apiaries down there next to all of the honey slimes, of course. And then maybe we can go back into the ancient ruins themselves and place a couple of them down there too. Maybe we can get some special echoes that way, who knows. But we'll have to bring back some more friends for our little quantum slimes as well. And we'll see if we can find any more of those very, very special treasure pods for even more decorations for our ranch. So if we jump down here again and activate our gadget mode, then we can still place down items here. Excellent. So let's place one right next to this little puddle over here. We can place one of our pumps in this area, right by the entrance, so we won't have to go too far to collect all of our rewards, of course. We'll put one of our apiaries here, and then I do want to place one of the drills too, just to see if we get anything different, just for a little bit of experimenting. I guess we'll have to place it way, way, way back here with all of the chickens. These little chickens are going to be taking care of our drill, hopefully, keeping it away from the tars, right guys? You're gonna do your part and make sure the tars don't get to all of our items. And of course, we'll place our other items as close to the entrance of the ancient ruins as we possibly can, so that we don't lose track of them, because there are so many twists and turns in this place that we are very likely to lose our way. For that matter, hopefully we can figure out where that little map node is in this place too. I didn't find one last time, but there has to be one somewhere. And we can place another one way, way back here, a little apiary next to all of the fireflies. Hopefully the phosphor slimes will be able to take care of our gadgets too. Now let's flip the switch and go a little bit deeper into the labyrinth again to see if we can find that map node. Honestly, I think if we get high enough on top of this place, we might be able to get a better idea of where we are. So if we can find a way to fly up where all of the trees were, we can get a nice bird's eye view, just like the one that we ended with in the last episode. Yeah, this is looking familiar. Okay, so let's get a good bird's eye view and see if we can find that glowing map node, because that would help us out so much if we could see where we actually are on this map. Oh, and look at that, we can also see where we placed all of our extractors. Oh, that is so helpful. Then we won't have to worry about forgetting where we placed them all. There's even a little island system over here too. I wonder if we need like a special warp pad to get to there? Maybe something by one of the Gordos. We did find a big boom Gordo somewhere very deep in the labyrinth, so I wouldn't be surprised if he's hiding something special. Oh, there it is, right there by that tree. Oh my goodness, you were hidden away off in a tiny little corner, and we have all of our tabby friends flying in on the backs of the phosphor slimes. How adorable is that? So if you guys are looking for this node too, it's some kind of right in the middle of the place, right over here next to that tree. Let's go ahead and activate this so we can see the whole world properly. Oh my goodness, look how giant this place is. And not only that, but it didn't actually give us access to this very mysterious little island over here. So I guess it counts as a completely unique area. We still haven't gone back into the quarry either to grab the map node there, so we are going to have to do that very, very soon. Maybe in the next episode we'll take a trip there to try to find some of the treasure pods too. I'm sure there are plenty of treasure pods in that quarry somewhere. But let's try to snag up some of these quantum slimes to bring back to our ranch too, before they end up turning all into Largos, because then we won't be able to bring them back with us. Oh my gosh, and before these nasty tars eat them all away. No, 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 little guy, let's save you. You can, oh my gosh, be a part of our ranch. I don't have any food on me, you guys. Oh no, there's only like shriveled up carrots over here too. And I'm sure a lucky slime has no interest in that. Not only that, but I think it went straight into the water. Poor little guy. But there's the boom Gordo too. We were trying to find a way to get into his lair. And I'm assuming that we probably need to open that door down there. But I don't see any sorts of little switches in the area. So I wonder if we'll just have to press some of these switches at random and hope that it happens to open that door. Let's see if maybe that one worked. I think that typically opens the main gate that leads us back out of here. But let's see if maybe the door to the Gordo is open. Yeah, I think it actually is. Well, I'm not sure if this is the right door, but let's investigate. Let's scoot a little bit deeper. It does seem like we can maybe fly up here with our jetpack, and this must be the room where he lives. Oh my goodness. Hopefully you're not going to explode anytime soon. I have a feeling that that would send us straight off into the water just like that. I'm a very unfortunate lucky slime. Oh, there's another one of the treasure pods, but it's a little bit more advanced than the current cracker that we have, so we won't be able to open that, but you're guarding some sort of treasure deep inside your lair. So hopefully by the time we gather up enough chickens for you, because the booms only eat meat, so we're going to have lots and lots of chickens. Hopefully by then we'll be able to upgrade our treasure cracker too. I don't see any more of the green treasure pods though. We're up very, very high to get another good view of the place. I think that might be like part of the moss jungle though, the moss blanket rather, or the quarry, because we have those strange rock formations again. So we're still very close to the other biomes, which is quite interesting. They're all very, very tightly packed together. We actually know that there is a little way for us to get to the quarry from the main area with that big door. There's another one of those slime doors right next to it that I'm assuming we could open to get to the quarry really fast. That would actually give us a shortcut back to the reef as well, so it might be worthwhile for us to do once we get another one of those slime keys. It looks like there's actually two slime keys for us to get inside the ruins. We've only seen one Gordo so far, so there must be someone else tucked very, very far away in here somewhere. Maybe even behind one of these giant doors. Oh my gosh, a yellow echo! There's a yellow one over here. I don't think we've ever seen this before. A gold echo. Oh, that's going to look really nice next to all of the other little twinkling lights that we have around our ranch. Those must be a little bit trickier to get our hands on because I don't think we've seen a single one in our entire time here. There is a little platform way up there though, so let's see if we can fly to it with our jetpack. Luckily, we have upgraded our jetpack quite a bit in the meantime, so we should be able to have enough energy to get all the way there, right? It's going to be quite tricky. We might even need to go along the side of the wall over here if we can. And not only that, but that is a straight drop down into the ocean too, so we're going to have to be very, very careful about this. Let's see if we can make it. I think we can. We have just enough energy to get all the way over here. I think this might be somewhere new too. It looks very different from the main area. I don't think we've been here before. Yeah, this is definitely a different area that we haven't explored before. Let's take a look at it on our map actually. Yeah, it looks like we have a little teleporter to go back to our home. And what on earth is this thing too? There's a giant circle with a light in the middle? That must be inside that building right there. So let's make sure that we don't accidentally go through the teleporter, because I have a feeling that's like that one that tricked us back in the amass blanket too, and we probably won't be able to get back anytime soon. We'll have to walk all the way back over here. I definitely want to see one of the strange devices though. It seems like it's very far down. Can we get to it right now? Oh, it's another one of the slime keys. Oh, of course. So we need yet another slime key to get to whatever that light was, it seems. That is where we are, right? Yeah, very, very close by. It seems to be blocking whatever that light is. So I guess it's time to reopen the Gordo Buffet. We need to go Gordo hunting again. It looks like there are some different pathways that we could take, though, that might lead us into some of those other buildings, too. So why don't we give that a try as well before we go back to our extractors and see if we have any new ingredients. Oh, for that matter, we do kind of have our pockets full right now, don't we? We might have to take a little trip back to the ranch first so that we can actually vacuum all of these resources up. Oh my goodness, there's a giant pool party taking place down here with echoes too. Oh, tons and tons of gold echoes and puddle slimes flying out of the pipes. Oh my gosh, you guys, you are going to be very, very shy here, aren't you? There are so many slimes in the area, they must be feeling very, very upset. They were expecting a nice, calm little pool to swim around in, and instead they found themselves smack in the middle of yet another party. The poor puddle slimes can never catch a break. This guy looks like he's doing okay, though. He's even given us some little tiny plorts. At least he's having fun. He found a very, very secluded portion of the pool to spend some time in. It looks like all of those pathways kind of just wrap around to the main area, actually, so we're not really finding anything new here. No new Gordos, unfortunately, but they must be around here somewhere. They must be in one of these nooks and crannies, probably very, very deep in the labyrinth, too, since that's where we found that boom Gordo. But yeah, I guess in the next episode, we're going to have to do a little bit of a Gordo feeding. Not that they would ever complain with getting the extra food, of course, but we are going to have to make sure that we have plenty of chickens, because I think at this point, most of the Gordos that we have our eyes on do actually want just meat, just chickens, so it's going to be a little bit trickier for us to feed them. But yeah, we have some gold echoes now to a place around our house as well. Oh, they're so much brighter too. Look how gorgeous those are. Let's put one at the very tippity top too. And then combined with all of our rewards from the 7Z Corporation, this place is going to be looking pretty fancy pretty soon. And in fact, since we haven't used any of our new bucks since, let's go ahead and upgrade our ranch a little bit more. We can get the porch upgrade, and then chroma stations. Once we become a Skylark, we get the chroma station, the cobalt chroma, and the milkshake chroma. Okay, let's investigate this. Let's see what the chromas are. It looks like it even gave us a little bit of star mail too to explain the chroma packs. Miss LeBeau, the 7Z Corporation would like to congratulate you on obtaining the rank of Skylark 1. With this rank, you now have access to the Avenue of Creative Self-Expression, chroma packs. Chroma packs allow you to apply new color schemes to your ranch house, vacpack, and ranch tech, allowing you to stand out from all the other ranchers on the far, far range. And while we realize that most slime ranchers never even see another rancher, given the geographic separation between your rancher properties, we have a feeling that they know. Oh yes, they know. Please also note that by the time you have likely read this message, the 7C Corporation has already installed a ChromaPack terminal just outside your home. Oh, they're very, very quick, aren't they? Very sneaky, too. Where on earth are these people coming from? The 7C Corporation, covertly installing machines outside your home quickly and reliably. Well, thank you very much. It sounds like we can use them to change the color of our house and our backpack. Oh, that's going to be cool. And not only that, but look at this new porch that we have, too. To match the lovely fence that we have by our garden. And oh my goodness, is that a little slime face? How adorable is that? Oh, I love this. I absolutely love all of these new decorations. I'm so glad that we spent a little bit of extra new bucks on the 7Z Corporation. But let's take a look at the chroma packs before we end out the episode. We have the classic chroma pack right now, which I guess is the gold and black color. But now we've unlocked the milkshake color and the cobalt color as well. So this is going to change our house. Let's see what the milkshake color looks like. Oh my gosh, that was very, very quick. Oh, that's so pretty. It even changed our little slime on top to that purple color. Oh my gosh, that is perfect. Purple is my favorite color, so I think we are going to go with that for at least a little while. And then I guess we can change the tech and the vac section separately. So let's change our vac over to the cobalt color to test them both out, I suppose. Oh, that's a nice color too. That really deep blue. It goes well with the blue spiral in the middle as well. So our ranch is really starting to come along. We have some brand new little quantum slimes to place inside the lab with all of their friends, and hopefully pretty soon we'll be able to go back and collect some brand new resources from all of our extractors as well. But let's open up the Slimepedia to read one more of these slime entries before we end out the episode. The honey slimes this time. Oh my gosh, they are absolutely adorable. The honey slimes have to be one of my favorites actually, aside from the cats, the hunters, and the tabbies. So honey slimes are an odd breed of slime composed of a hyper-sweet slime compound. Most slime scientists believe this to be the result of their slime cells replicating the natural sugars found in the fruits and floral nectars of the far, far range. Most ranchers agree that their plorts taste great on cereal. Oh, so you can actually eat the honey slime plorts too. That's good to know. The greatest danger a honey slime poses is found in their plorts. Honey plorts are the sweetest, most delicious plorts known on the far, far range. Other slimes can detect them from much farther away than a normal plort and will do everything in their means to get them. A rancher with honey slimes needs to be careful about unintended largos or worse. Yeah, I guess that means that wherever the honey slimes are, we are likely to see many, many more tars. Greedy tars who want all of the honey plorts for themselves. Honey plorts are highly prized by food manufacturers. Though the plorts are naturally incredibly sweet, the discovery that they could be further refined into an even sweeter substance made the demand soar. These refined honey plorts are said to score an unprecedented 867 on the Werner Thompkins Hong Sacrino scale, just a few points shy of not fit for human consumption. Oh geez, imagine the people bouncing off the walls when they get their hands on the refined honey plorts. That must be quite the sugar rush. But for now, thank you all so much for watching, and I'll see you all next time. Bye, guys!